Yeah, I took a little time off, you know, like a couple of weeks is a lot for me. I got a call from a good friend of mine, a respected not only a friend, but a respected artist that I respect a lot, and that's Randy Houser. And, you know, he was like, I've always wanted to do something, whatever, but, you know, you were doing something separate, and whatever, when you can come out, let's collaborate a little bit, and let's make some music together. You can play guitar, and I was like, absolutely. That made sense to me, because I wouldn't have just, you know, I'm not a musical snob, but there's definitely people that I would enjoy to go play with and go play for more than others. I mean, he's, you know, one of those guys. And now, having hindsight, it's exactly what I thought it would be. I had a blast. It was so much fun. The music was awesome. It was also a vehicle for some of the Halfway to Hazard fans to come see me play, and they did. They supported me even when I was playing, you know, playing some shows with Keith Anderson or Randy or whatever. They would still show up, and that just shows their loyalty. And a couple months ago, I was in town, a local, kind of went out to have a beer or something before a bus call, and I had a fan recognize me from Halfway to Hazard, and they came, oh, can I have your autograph, and the whole deal, whatever. Literally, like 2 minutes after that, this guy came, you play guitar for Randy Houser, can I have your autograph? So it was bizarre, within 2 minutes, two different people that had, he had no idea anything about Halfway to Hazard and whatever, but he recognized me as being guitar player for Houser, and then this other friend was like, so it's funny, you know. So I think we, you know, I progressed that way. I made some new fans out there that now are interested in following me and want to know what I'm doing, and that's what it's all about.